Okay. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay. Okay. Today I'm very happy because today is our turn to give you some our experience or our little knowledge we know. So today we have special teaching training for the doctor student in second year. So today we have we will talk about the definition, the function, forest ecosystem and its function. So our today topic is about the today is about the forest ecosystem and its function. So today there are three we'll present it. First is my part, is Ali, and then we'll continue by the Jinsan and Sosan. So in my first, you can see in the handout. So we can see in the handout in the first slide, my part is about the definition and the function of the forest ecosystem. Second part is type of forest, or how to classify the forest. Or to make a name of the one forest unit. The next is the forest function in general, and then specific forest function for the water resource, and the flood control, and the how the forest ecosystem can reduce the effect urban native islands. So first, I have a question for you all. So we have the start from the definition. Whoever go to the forest, dari kamu di kitab atau gak ada. So what you see?
Trees.
Let's start from the trees. Another one?
Yes.
Grass.
Okay. Another one?
White.
Yeah. Maybe bird. Another one? Another one? Okay.
River.
We have river. One more.
Bush.
Okay. So, we can see the term and definition of the forest. So first, we have this is the land area. First, the minimum of the land area of the forest, 0.5 hectare. First, so this is area should be 0.5 hectare. So in the forest unit, we have three. So we have the minimum of the three. So not all of the three can be used as the forest unit. So we have the minimum of the height of the tree. This tree is minimum in 5 meters. This is the tree. So, and then after the tree, not only one area, there's only one tree. This cannot call the forest. So we need some trees again, and the coverage, the canopy should be more than 10% to cover of the land area. So we can get the term, definition of the forest as a unit is the land area with the minimum tree with the height of 5 meters and the coverage more than 10%. And this is not for agriculture products. So we can see in the term, in the slides, there are some criteria, but in the last part is, so how about the, like I say, palm tree. So we have the same part, but because they're palm tree for the agriculture, this is not included as a forest. So this is not forest. Because they palm oil. Even there are birds there inside, there are some river inside, or grass or brush. So they cannot call forests if they used for the agriculture. So one more again, the forest is the land area with more than 0.5 hectare and the minimum height of the tree is 5 meter and the coverage of the canopy is more than 10%. This is definition of forest as a unit. So today we will talk about the forest ecosystem. So what the forest ecosystem? So we have bird here. Maybe there are, okay, this is, sorry, this is water. Sunrise. Sunlight. Okay, the sun. So the interaction in this area between bird, water, soil, maybe some the insect or some the animal, the interaction of the this is biotic. So interaction between the biotic component and abiotic component inside the forest unit we call the forest ecosystem. So what biotic? Biotic is the living. Abiotic is not living. Biotic like bird, tree, grass, bush, that's the biotic. And abiotic is the river, soil, there are stone. This is called abiotic. So the interaction between all components inside this area, this is called the forest ecosystem. Okay. Next. So in the forest ecosystem, in the forest science, we have the some classification of the layer. So we make layering. Big trees, small trees, and some bush, grass, soil. So, in the forest, like this, we can find it in the several layers. First is the ground. In the forest, rainforest, they call emergent. So this is only maybe in 1 hectare or more, 1,000 hectare, just only 2 or 3 trees is very high. This is called an emergent layer. Just in the tropical in the rainforest area. So but commonly just the forest floor or ground, understory, canopy, and then until the canopy. So why we need to divide it? Because you can open in the slide and the forest layer in a beautiful picture. So because in the every layer have a different animal, different plant will grow. So that maybe grass will grow in the ground or just some bird will hear, or some the like tiger just in the this understory or just hear something near the canopy. So the layering of the forest ecosystem is important to classify the different the animal which place they will suitable to live in. So in this part, maybe for the bird to make a nest, or some bird to avoid the enemy, or some the tiger to looking for the some prey or some fish. So we need the two layering of the forest to make the more easy classified the which animal or organism living in the different layers. And next,
sometimes maybe we ever hear about the
temperate, evergreen,
coniferous forest. Whoever here or whoever know what this word? Temperate, evergreen, coniferous forest. How this name come? So, in the forest science, we have the part to classification of forest or to make a name of forest based on the four categories. So the first category is classification model. First is phytoclimatic. Second, let's start from the first one. We start from the word of the phytoplimate. Parts. So climate. Yeah, maybe easy. Still, we call climate. Phyto is another word for the plant. Plant and climate. So this is plant, the plant grow depend on climate. But more easy, you can see, our globe